Hey guys, welcome to my channel. This episode is going to be a good one because we're going to cover one of the main concepts behind the operations of your fish finder, which has to do with the use of multiple frequencies. So if you would like to learn more about how your fish finder operates, don't go away. It's all coming right up.
There's no need to freak out. There's nothing wrong with the video signal. We'll be in the dark for just a little bit and then you'll see why. In order to get a good grasp on the effects of using different sonar frequencies, we need to perform a little mental exercise. In your mind, let's replace your fish finder's transducer by a flashlight. Yes, a flashlight. Much like a flashlight, your fish finder's transducer uses a beam to detect fish, cover, and structure. However, this beam is not made of light, but of sound. This is incredible technology. In water, sound travels 4.3 times faster than in air. This means sound travels almost 4,900 feet per second through the water. Amazing, isn't it? Higher frequencies, particularly chirp frequencies, use a narrow but focused beam very similar to what we're seeing on the screen right now. The diameter of the area covered by this beam will be a function of the frequency you configure your fish finder to use. Let me repeat that. The diameter of the area covered by this beam will be a function of the frequency you configure your fish finder to use. In general, high frequencies use smaller beam angles, which result in smaller coverage areas, as exemplified by the beam and coverage area you are seeing on the screen at the moment. Remember that chirp frequencies produce high-resolution images with much more detail compared to those produced by regular frequencies. In addition to greater detail, chirp will produce images with better target separation and decreased water column clutter. Now let's adjust our flashlight to simulate a lower frequency on your sonar. As you can see, we now have a much wider coverage area, but the image doesn't look as clear as before. Pretty much what happens when you use a low sonar frequency. You end up being able to cover a little bit more water at the expense of image clarity and target separation. Lower frequencies use wider beam angles, which translate into bigger coverage areas. Being able to cover more water is certainly an advantage lower frequencies have over higher frequencies. However, the image quality and target separation typically produced by lower frequencies is not as high as what you get when using chirp. So, does this mean you always need to use higher frequencies such as chirp? Well, not at all. While chirp is very good at detecting structure and cover, it is not so good at detecting fish. On the other hand, while lower frequencies don't produce very high quality images, they are very good at detecting fish and much more suitable for deeper waters. So, as you can see, low and high frequencies complement each other. Each has its own place and application. Of course, the ideal situation would be to have a fish finder that supports both types of frequencies. In any case, now you know the importance of being aware of what frequencies or frequencies you have configured your unit to use, as they will have a big impact not only on the amount of water you're able to cover, but also the fish detection capabilities and clarity of the images you get.
Well, I hope that now you're able to see the importance of selecting the right frequencies on your unit. If you'd like to learn more about fish finders, I have a couple of videos in my channel. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. My name is Robert, and as always, take care, and I'll see you in the next one.